Welcome to ABC Gluten Free. Thank you for joining us today. We have our show today is dedicated to congenital heart disease. Today is Wear Red Day. So as you can see, we're all wearing red. And we wanted to support congenital heart disease because, of course, I am a survivor. So if you guys are interested or you want more information, you can go to savetheheartbeat.org or you can go to adultcongenitalheartassociation.org. And you can learn more about it, or you can donate. Being born with a congenital heart defect means that you have a lifelong defect that you really have to take care of and watch out for. And we're hoping that the government and the health benefits will start to provide a little bit more for adults as they get older, so that we can have some better care as we grow up. Because as you know, you're in a pediatric cardiology, they get taken care of very well, but as you become an adult, kind of slips away a little bit. So we want to support that, and we hope that you go to one of the websites and check it out. Possibly donate if you can. Maybe save a life. Maybe someone that you know or someone that you care for maybe someday might have something like that. So today we're dedicating our show to all of those out there that have a congenital heart defect, all of those out there suffering from any heart defect really. We want to just support you, and we want to share with you some of our delicious happy heart recipes. So we're going to get started. You guys know my beautiful helper Sophia and my super helper Jeremiah. And you guys know Sophia is 11 and Jeremiah is 16, and they told me that I couldn't have any children, and I have two beautiful kids. So if someone tells you that, make sure you just trust in the Lord and say your prayers and pray for a miracle. And you never know, something like this may happen for you too. You guys ready 16, to work?
11.
Yeah. Are you guys ready to work?
Yeah.
What are we making today?
Heart.
They know a little bit, but not too much. So we're going to get started because we do have four things we want to make for you today. We have to feed gluten-free grandma. We want to make sure that she gets well fed so the mess gets cleaned up really well. And the first thing we're going to get started on today is our delicious scones. Are you guys ready to make some scones? Now, we do make scones a lot, because we really love them, because I like them little and they're just so delicious to have. So today we're making a version for you with using our excess energy drink, because it has a lot of B vitamins in it. And okay, stop. We're using a mango pineapple guava blended one, and we love this one because it has a lot of heart healthy options. Mango, pineapple, and guava all have healthy heart benefits. Now Sophia can show you this. Actually, this is a chart that we like to refer to a lot, because as you know, if you have a heart defect, you really have to take care of yourself, and you really have to make sure you supplement. I use Double X. It probably has kept me as healthy as I am today. But you want to make sure you're hitting all of the five colors of the phytonutrients. So today we have a nice big bowl of beautiful colors. You want to make sure you get 5 to 9 servings of fruits and vegetables, and if you don't, you want to fill in your gaps or just add to that. So this actually tells you a little bit about what each color is for, and we're going to talk a little bit about, we're going to talk to you about that today a little bit as we go. But this is just our Neutralite supplement guide, and that tells you all about what the colors are for, and how the red is healthy for your heart, and the white is good for your veins and vascular, and the green is good for your cellular. And so we're just going to talk a little bit about those things, not too much. We're not medical, we're not doctors, so we're just giving you what's good for us and our story, and we just want to share that with you. But we're going to get started on the scones. We've got to get started on the scones. Let's go, guys. All right, so we're just using our gluten-free flour blend, and Sophia's going to put 1 cup of the gluten-free flour blend in the bowl. Our gluten-free flour blend varies kind of from day to day almost here. Today we're using a Namaste blend, and we love Namaste. It's vegan, dairy-free, egg-free, soy-free. I believe it's also corn-free. I can't remember. But today we're adding some Kerrygold, pure, delicious, beautiful gold Irish butter. And thank you to Rose for sending us that gorgeous shipment.
Did she say delicious?
Yes, it's Sophia's only butter that she'll eat. It's the only butter she'll put on anything or inside anything. She doesn't like to have anything else. So we're very, very thankful that Rose sent that to us. And being that it's the only butter that we can have, dairy product, we're very thankful that it's healthy for us and it's filled with some great vitamins and minerals. You making a smiley face in there? Good. Jeremiah's going to add about 4 tablespoons of butter. Jeremiah, we need 3 more of those. And Sophia's just going to blend them up in the dough. We're not going to add any sugar. We're going to use a little bit of agave today because it's a low glycemic. Now, you know, if you have a heart challenge or diabetes or kidney problems, you want to go low glycemic. You don't want to put any more stress on your body to try to digest all of those sugars. So you want to go with low glycemic. And it really is a healthier option unless you're using something like a maple syrup or a honey, more natural products that your body can readily digest. Those are good for you. We're going to use some baking powder, about 1 teaspoon of baking powder. Jeremiah, would you measure 1 teaspoon of this for me, please? You're going to have to get the measuring spoon. Now, Sophia's just blending the butter into the flour. She's going to make it like a little sand texture. And this really would be easy if you put it in the blender. It's a little 1, 2, 3 in the food processor. And we're going to be using our excess energy drink in there, along with our baking powder. And we have one flax egg, which I'm going to tell you, it's 1 tablespoon of brown flax, which is very healthy for you. It has a lot of the B vitamins, the omegas, and it's really a really heart healthy thing. We're substituting our egg for that. And we also have some almond milk in here with a little bit of apple cider vinegar. That's going to be like our version of buttermilk. Because when you're making scones, like my husband's grandmother's traditional way of making scones was with buttermilk. She never put an egg in it, so they have this dilemma and this discrepancy in their family, egg or no egg in the scones. So it's completely up to you. If you want to swap out the flax egg for a regular egg, you'll do 1 egg. And if you want to swap out the buttermilk, you'll do about 1/2 cup of regular buttermilk, regular milk, soy milk, nut milk, or you can do 1/2 and 1/2, heavy cream, whatever it is that you want to use. And then we're going to use about 1/2 cup of our energy drink. All right, Sophia, don't worry about it, honey. It's okay. It's a piece of butter in there?
Yeah.
Oh, you got it. Good girl. All right, so now I'm going to let them just kind of put the ingredients in. Now, we're not adding any extra flavor to this because we have this energy drink flavor. Jeremiah, easy on this water, Sophia. Let's do this one last. Jeremiah, get all that flax out of there. And for our scones, we're going to do a really simple, rough kind of thing. Jeremiah's going to get us our heart-shaped pan. We're making heart-shaped scones today for, obviously, congenital heart disease awareness. I'm going to do a little bit of the buttermilk. Let Mommy do it and you mix. Go ahead. And then, Jeremiah, we're just going to need you to grease that with our tiger nut oil. And I'm going to add some of our energy drink here, and Sophia's going to keep mixing. So that should be enough. Let's wait and see. You might want to play the wet dry game today. I don't know. Did you? Jeremiah, move the bottle out of the way, please. All right, so she's just going to mix that up. Now, you notice that we didn't add any flavoring to it. Can you stop for 1 second? We only added the excess energy drink. I'm only going to do a teeny bit of agave, like 1/2 teaspoon, because we don't need it because we have our sweetness from the fruits in here. Now
and
remember,
has no sugar.
Right, excess is no sugar and low carbs. Let's see, how many carbs are in this one? This one has 10 because it's 25% fruit juice from a concentrate. So this actually has in it pear, mango, pineapple, guava, lots of goody goodies. And it's got a lot of potassium in here, so when you have a heart defect, you always want to make sure you keep up on your potassium. It's very important. Yep, okay, you can stop stirring now. You're good to go. Leave your fork in there, honey.
Look at how nice it comes out.
Yeah, she's got a really nice dough right here. Now, when you're making a scone mix, sometimes you get a little bit dry, crumbly, and that's okay. You can add a little bit more liquid. But if you want, a lot of people like to coat theirs in oat flour. Gives it that nice crunch on the outside. But since we're putting it in the pans, we don't really need to do that because it's just not really going to happen. So Sophia is actually going to put this in our little heart pan. I just want to show you our heart pan. Oh, thank you, Miss Jeannie gave this to us. We love when we get foodie gifts. We call them foodie gifts because foodies give foodie good gifts. Foodies give foodies good gifts. Yep, we don't want it to overflow, so just a small amount. Yeah, try that and see. And these are going to go in the oven 375 for maybe at the most 17 minutes. I'll let Jeremiah test them at 12. Then we'll go to 15 if we have to, and then 17 if we need to. So since we don't need any more of this, I'm going to put this to the back. For our happy hearts today, we're making the heart-shaped scones. We're making them heart healthy. We're using that flax. We're using that really, really good gluten-free flour blend. It's got a lot of good, it's got brown rice in it. And if you look up some of these ancient grains and these really good flours, you'll see the health benefits of them. I'm not going to tell them all to you because you can look them up for yourself. But they have a lot of health benefits in them. Thank you. So if you're concerned about the carbs and all of that, okay, this is just going to be a little dessert for you. So, you know, we don't want to overload you on the carbs. We are going to do something fried today. That's just the way that we go. But we are also including a lot of our veggies. So we want you guys to enjoy yourselves. We hope you BYON, Rachel.
Bring your napkin.
Bring your own napkin. And we hope you have your pen and paper to write this down because we didn't write any of this down today. We have nothing ready. We have nothing written down for you. So we'll have to get on that this week. But I just want to show you here as Sophia goes through, as she puts the scones in the platter, in the pan there. We've got a lot of different colors here, and it's always great to eat your rainbow. So if you eat 2 servings of each color of the rainbow, you'll get 10 servings of fruits and vegetables for your day, which would be really great. So we have 2 whites or a yellow. We have garlic and an onion. We have a beautiful red, a nice red pepper. We have a nice green avocado, and you know that's some healthy fats in there. We have a yam and a sweet potato, 2 different colors, but they're very good for you. We've got, I think this is a purple, and this is an orange, so they're both really healthy for you. Now, we have, you know, a lot of clues that God gave us when he made these things, which are incredible to me. When you cut open the onion, you'll see a lot of lines and a lot of, it's almost like veins. This is very good for vascular. When you cut open that carrot, you see it's almost the shape of an eye with the iris, and that's good for your eyes.
And this is the shape of a heart.
Yeah, and we've got reds for our hearts and our blood. It's very good. Yeah. And you know, this just all gives you brain power, and you always want to keep your heart healthy because that's going to feed the rest of your body, pumping that blood.
And this
we've got garlic. Yeah, garlic is good for you. All right, so Jeremiah, you put those in the oven?
Yep.
All right, so we're going to get started next on our donuts. Actually, we're doing a sausage pancake donut today. Now, last week we did a maple bacon donut, and we really loved them, and we wanted to make like a nice kind of like a heart-healthy brunch or breakfast, and this would be all of the things that I would pick. So when Jeremiah was little and my dad was still alive, we used to go to Dunkin' Donuts. And what did you get at Dunkin' Donuts?
You got the sausage wrapped up in the pancake covered in maple syrup.
And they were so yummy. So last week when we were talking about that, I said, oh, let's just make that. So Jeremiah's going to get us the sausage, and we're going to cut those into small pieces. Now, today we're using a chicken sausage that we actually bought at Aldi's. And it has, it says never any. So it's no antibiotics, none of that stuff. So it's chicken raised without antibiotics, hormones, and it's on a vegetarian diet, which, okay, whatever. But it's chicken breakfast sausage, and we really like this. I mean, if we can't get Martin sausage, this would be our next pick, or Applegate, one or the other. So they're very, very similar. So what you guys are going to do is cut them into small pieces like this, maybe like a little smaller than an inch, and we're going to put these right into our batter. I'm going to get going on the batter, and this is a really simple batter we made, like, similar last week. So we're going to do a cup of flour, our gluten-free flour, and today we're using Namaste.
This
doesn't
make it all.
Jeremiah, careful, please.
Be very careful, buddy.
Okay, we're going to add the rest of our buttermilk that we have. Now, if I needed more, I could have made some more buttermilk with the almond milk. Almonds are very heart healthy, especially when you have them raw, if you can get them raw. As raw as possible. Get a bowl to put them in when you're done. I put about a teaspoon of baking powder in there.
Wait, Mom, how big? An inch?
And I'm using maple syrup instead of sugar, because we want to make sure gluten-free dad can have some.
So do your thumb.
About 1 tablespoon of maple syrup. What did you say to me, honey? I'm sorry.
1 inch.
A little bit less than an inch, I said. No, cut that in half. Cut those in half, please. Those are too big. Cut them in half. So we're adding about 1/4 to 1/2 cup of seltzer. save the rest for our drink. We're making a really delicious Shirley Temple, so make sure you stick around for that. That's going to be yummy. Alright, I'm just going to stir this up. Now, we have our fryer on 375. We have our non-GMO sunflower oil. So, sunflower oil is a healthier option for you. It's way healthier than canola oil, which I hope you're not using. It would be similar to like a avocado oil or, let me think. I'm trying to think of what else. I'll have to get back to you on that. So the sunflower oil is a better option. And if you can't have peanuts, you're not using peanut oil. Canola oil is probably the worst one you could use, or corn oil. They're both very highly genetically modified, and it's very difficult to find ones that aren't. All right, so we've got our little sticky batter here. We might need a little bit more liquids in here. But as you can see, it's very simple to put together. This took me like, what, 2 minutes? The kids cut up the sausage. You okay? Don't use an apron. Come on. Oh. Sophia's getting dirty today.
I keep wiping myself.
Yeah?
In the skirt area.
Oh, you don't want to wipe your skirt. She's got such a beautiful skirt on today. It's filled with hearts. Maybe I'll get a picture for you guys later so we can show you. So if you have a congenital heart defect, I just want to give you a shout out. If you guys want to comment on the bottom or you want to send us a message on Facebook, we'd love to post your picture and your story, your testimony, and just tell us how healthy you're trying to keep yourself. All right, so I've got my batter done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to... Is it nice and spongy?
This is very spongy.
So I've got big, I've got small. Everybody always says
big,
and I always say
small.
So I'm going to make some small. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to take a little bit of batter on my spoon, and I'm going to stuff it with that.
That's not fun.
Why not?
It's small. Too small.
But watch how big it gets when it goes into the fryer. And I'm just going to cover it up with some of the batter, and I'm going to drop it right into the fryer. Now, as this is going, you guys don't need to see that do a million times. We're going to get started on our sweet potato hash. You're not dropping anything in the fryer. No. Okay. Jeremiah, that's enough, honey.
You only get one.
I know, but you're going to make them all big, and then we're going to only have, like, two.
Don't worry, I'm doing this.
All right, baby. And then you give it to me, and I'll drop it in the fryer. It's very easy, and actually, you can make these up ahead of time, roll them, put them on a piece of plastic and put them in the freezer, and then when you feel like having them Sunday morning, you're all set to go. Ooh, they're coming up. Yay. All right, one more.
You guys start on the next thing.
Yes, can I have my West then, please? We're going to get started on the sweet potato hash. Now, this is probably my top favorite thing to eat. Sweet potatoes are one of the healthiest potato for you. They're anti-inflammatory. So this is really good potato for you to have. It also has a lot of potassium. Don't argue. It has a lot of potassium, so it's really good for your heart. It also has some of those B vitamins that you need to keep going. All right, that's enough, guys. One more. Jeremiah, you gotta shake it when you put it down. Go ahead, put it in. Don't drop it too far away. You gotta shake it when you put it down so it doesn't stick to the bottom. All right, so we're going to get chopping vegetables. Sophia, go rinse this off. Jeremiah, put that away for now. What?
Big ones are nice.
They always want everything bigger. So what we're going to get started on is we're going to dice our onion and our garlic.
I'm not doing onion.
Gluten-free grandma's going to come to the rescue for this one. Or Jeremiah. Jeremiah, this isn't on, honey. I don't know what's wrong. Can you go check, please? All right, we've got our breakfast poppers cooking.
What are you doing? I can see the fryer, yeah.
Good girl. I'm going to unplug it for this moment.
I keep my hands off and you do that, okay?
You want me to try again?
Mm-hmm.
No, hold on 1 second. Yes, thank you. Okay, so we've got our West Bend on. This is our vintage West Bend. We take this thing everywhere. It is getting a little scraped up inside, but I really don't want to get rid of it. I love it so much. If I bought a new one, I don't know if it would work as well as this, and I don't know if it would be as light. It's like one of the lightest ones I've felt.
No,
Every time I go to the store, I take them out and I try to feel.
He had a growth spurt.
All right, Jeremiah, you cut the onion. Sophia, you cut the garlic and the pepper. And I will cut some of the yams.
Then etch on the heart of the pepper. The heart. Mommy, I'm touching them.
No, you don't touch. So, guys, I want to ask you, now don't get mad at Mommy, but what do you think of, Jeremiah, it went out again. Feels hot, though. Let's see. Well, wait, let me double check. I can't remember if the light goes on or off when you... Yeah, Jeremiah, it's not on. Can you check it, please? Growing up, my parents never babied me, but they did keep an eye on me. So I wasn't babied, but I was watched... Can I have that knife, please? But I was watched very carefully, but I was allowed to do almost everything. That's okay. So a lot of the times, you know, growing up with a defect or... any type of disease or disorder, you know, you might get babied, but I know that my parents always kind of let me do what I wanted, and I worked really hard, and I do remember being in the hospital. Do you remember when I was in the hospital, and I got to meet the gymnastics team for the Olympics? It was like Nadia Comaneci and some other people at Children's Hospital in Philadelphia, and I think that was the most exciting thing I ever did at the hospital anyway, because you know the hospital's like the hospital. And you never really want to be there. And when I went back after these two to have my last surgery after her, I saw so many changes in the hospital, but I was so thankful to be going home.
What do you want to ask us that we can
Well, I want to ask you, like, do you know, like, what is it like to have Mommy, like, with her heart defect? Like, does it, like, scare you, or do you don't mind, or you just pray for Mommy a lot, or, like, what?
I don't mind.
You don't mind? Because sometimes when you don't feel good, you know, you guys have to take care of me. What do you think about that?
Sophia likes.
She likes taking care of me? Or does she just like watching TV when she's
no.
with me?
Yes.
No.
Jeremiah gets everything that I need for me, and Sophia just stays by my side whenever I don't feel good. And then gluten-free grandma will be downstairs cooking whatever it is that we want. She goes to the store, she gets us our pineapple, she gets us our sweet potatoes. Right? And all of those things help you to heal. What would you take gluten-free grandma?
That's the least I could do.
Mm-hmm. Well, gluten-free grandma took care of me growing up, so you really don't need to do anything. You did your job. Sophia, Jeremiah, I think this is not on. Why? Okay, thank you. So I'm trying to just cut the sweet potatoes into nice little squares, nice little cubes. Jeremiah's actually the best at doing this. He cuts them into perfect cubes. Yeah, he is. He's good at that. So, I feel like our thing is hot, but not really hot. I don't know what's going on today. So, I'm going to let Jeremiah go check it out. Hopefully, he's going to see. Now, we've got Poppy in here from the chicken sausage. Oh, we've got a runner. We got somebody that got loose in here. We're going to leave that for a little bit so we can fix that. Now, if you have somebody run loose like we had, it's just because you didn't cover it all the way in your dough. Nice, Sophia. Thank you. So you want to make sure you cover it completely in the dough. It feels hot, Jeremiah, but I don't know. All right, so today we're using our tiger nut oil, and this actually repels the fat from getting absorbed into your food. Tiger nut oil is really healthy for you. And it's not a nut, it's a tuber.
A tuber.
Yes, and it's from Spain. And tiger nuts are actually something you can almost survive on. They have fiber, they have protein. Thank you, honey. She's cutting me hearts out of the peppers. It's very cute. Can I put my stuff in there, Jeremiah, or not yet? Okay. All right, Jeremiah's hooking me up over here. Thank God he's here today, that he can always... take care of our electronics and our little technical difficulties if we have them. So I'm just continuing to dice up the sweet potatoes. And when the last surgery I had was after Sophia, and I remember just asking them for pineapple, watermelon. Oh, I don't know. I didn't turn it off and on again. Usually the light goes on. There you go. Is it this? It looks like it's this. So I remember asking for watermelon and pineapple and all of those things that had a lot of potassium in them. And when I had my potassium tested, it was really super, super low. So they wanted to put me on a pill, and I wasn't too thrilled with that. So I went on the pill for a few days until I was able to stabilize. And actually, I used my vitamins, which have a lot of potassium in them. I used excess, and I also used a protein shake that excess has that has a lot of potassium in it, and that helped me to stabilize.
I got pepper juice on my chin.
Aw, let me see, all right. And I also made sure that I drink my perfect water. It's oxygenated, which obviously you can understand. Oxygen in your heart is a very important thing. So you want to make sure you stay oxygenated.
Very important.
Very important.
If you didn't have oxygen in your heart, you'd die.
Well, we breathe oxygen, don't we?
Yeah.
And how do we get oxygen?
From the trees.
From the trees.
People, stop cutting down trees. You're killing my oxygen.
This is the tree hugger's family.
She's the tree hugger, and she gets very upset when she sees people cutting down trees. But it's part of life, and if you cut them down, then you want to just plant some, right? Right?
You have to plant four when you cut
one. Oh, you cut one, you have to plant four?
Mm-hmm.
All right, so we have a nice orange sweet potato, and then we have this. Oh, this one's white.
Yes,
we've got the Japanese yam, which is really white. Look at that. It's beautiful. Can you see that? It's a gorgeous color. It almost looks like it's ginger or turmeric or something. Now we're just going to dice that up. We're going to do that a little smaller. You guys, Jeremiah, need onions and garlic in the pan. Sophia, when you're done, you put your peppers in there. So this is like my favorite thing in the morning. If I'm not juicing, I'll have a sweet potato or sweet potato hash or potato hash. Now, you can put meat in here if you want, and I know my kids like meat, but I'm good with just the potatoes, the
me
onions,
too.
And the garlic. Yes.
Except maybe not a lot of garlic.
The more garlic, the better for me. Unless gluten-free grandma's having some, then we don't want to hit her too hard with the garlic. All right, so this is going to saute in the pan a little
bit. Okay,
this is ready. Go ahead, we can toss it right in there. Good girl. Now we want to make sure we get a bunch of different colors in there. We want to hit all the notes. Aw, thank you. Mwah. Jeremiah, I'll take half of that. I don't want all of it, okay? Thank you. Good. You might as well. Go ahead.
Now, for the garlic, you want two or three cloves? I mean, one clove.
This one is good. Jeremiah, could cut the rest of that pepper for Sophia. We'll use that.
I forget to cut that.
That's okay, honey. All right, so I'm just going to saute this a little bit. I want to make sure that I soften them up. Sometimes the potatoes take a really long time, so if you wanted to and you have a cover, add a little bit of water and put the cover on, and that'll soften up the potatoes. And with the oil in it, then it'll give it a nice crisp on it, too. So you can do that if you like. Hopefully we cut them small enough that they'll be ready for us. You want me to check that while you guys are cutting?
Yeah.
All right, you guys start cutting. And Jeremiah, I want you to tell them, do you remember being at the Ronald McDonald House at all?
Yeah.
Let's tell them about it.
I remember Ronald McDonald and his house. And it was very bright and cheery and clowny. And there was good food and good ice cream and fun toys to play with.
You remember there were toys to play with?
Yeah.
What kind
there
of
was
food
like
you
a. There's like this room with arcade games and a PlayStation and stuff.
So if you've ever had the opportunity to have someone you love or you know stay at the Ronald McDonald House or benefit from it, we'd really appreciate it at Children's Hospital in Philadelphia. That while I was in the hospital, my children got to play there, which is kind of the opposite. It's usually the parent, not the parent with the child in the hospital, and you know you're taking your child to play it at Ronald McDonald House, or you're staying there because your child is in the hospital. So we had a little bit of the reverse situation. So I was in the actual children's hospital with a bunch of young kids around me, and I was able to share with some of the families there that, you know, here I am, 46 years old, I survived, I made it, being born with tetralogy of Fallot, so there's hope for your child or your sibling. You stirring it up? If I find the heart in there, do I get a kiss? This is my necklace from Sophia that she gave to me, and every time she puts her little key in the heart, we have to kiss each other, right? Is that what we do? She said, it works, it works. gotta get it in there the right way. There you go. Mwah. Mwah. Thank you. Take a break, alright? Alright, so we're just gonna stir up our little hash here. We lost a couple of our peppers on the side. We'll put those back on.
I got popped by pepper juice.
Yeah. And so with our look at how giant this is. This is gonna don't do that. Jeremiah, look how big this is.
I need syrup.
We need to cook a little bit more. You can put them over here for mommy.
Can I put them down?
No, you may not. No, you're not touching the fryer.
You need to cook more?
No. I don't know if these, let me try. They need the big ones because they're huge. Yeah, I'll put them down a little bit more. Just leave them in there. Just go out? No. No, I don't want that. Alright, so let me just... Well, I want to disperse this evenly so it cooks because I wasn't paying any attention to it. I'm going to add a little bit more of the tiger nut oil. Excuse me.
Oh no, I can't see my heart.
It's in there somewhere. Watch out, baby. I don't want this popping on you. Alright, so we're going to let our hash sit. Let it sit, honey.
Oh, no.
Just let it sit.
That was my heart.
Let it sit. Alright, we're going to clean up our mess right here. Sophia, you want to come and clean up the mess? What's the matter?
I'm looking for my heart.
No, it's in there. I saw it. You might have just broken it up. Yeah, just leave it. She has a heart-shaped pepper in there. She doesn't want to lose. So the reason I have the avocado is because we really like to have avocado on top of our sweet potato hash.
Love, not really love.
We love, right?
Love.
Jeremiah, let's clean up this stuff right here, and then maybe you can get started on our drink. Check the scones, okay? The scones, I forgot to tell the kids to flatten them out when we put them into the heart-shaped pan. So they kind of just puffed up as a scone instead of being heart-shaped. So I would have liked to have a little bit of a different shape on that. Good thing we have a little bit more batter. We could do it again. Jeremiah, if you take the scones out and put them on a cooling rack up here.
Sorry.
What? Sorry, baby.
I didn't have to do that.
That's okay.
Where's the batter?
No, you're not doing it. I am. I'm going to let those cook a little bit more. So it might take about 10 minutes in the fryer. I think our fryer went out and came back on. I'm not really sure if that happened or not. This is for our
scones.
Where's our... Oh, okay, we don't need that right now. Put that away. Don't play with it, please. Why don't we get the batter for the sausage?
And
oh,
the
yeah,
sausage.
So see? Just put it down. So, the kids didn't shape them into the heart shape. So what we'll do is, Jeremiah, if you get a cooling rack, we'll take these out and we'll do it again. You want to make a few and I'll drop them in.
I make some small ones for you, Mommy.
Okay. You have to cover it all the way, though. All right. Thank you, Jeremiah. Yeah, you can just dump that. All right. So we're just going to take out our little bitty scones. Look how cute these are. These are little bitties. Jeremiah's going to do one more round. Jeremiah, can you fill that up and squish them down so they'll make a heart shape? And I'm just going to open this up a little bit so I can see. Oh, these are nice.
Let me take.
No, we're going to make the topping for it. We have to do a little bit of that. Mm. They're nice and soft, though. Look how Sophia covered that sausage up nice. Hold on 1 minute. I need to take them off.
I did not touch it. Oh, that's not good.
Now, I'm going to take our little fried breakfast poppers and leave them here for a little bit to cool. Don't touch this. It's hot. You hear me? Okay. And I'm gonna put down a few more. Sophia made for me. Good job, baby.
I just need one big one today.
All right, I'll trade you. Now, when you drop them into the fryer, you just want to give your basket a little shake so they don't stick to the basket. If they stick to the basket, you'll have a hard time getting them out, and they won't come to the top. So you'll maybe burn them. I don't know. You don't want to do that. Thank you, honey. Yeah. See, when you have teamwork in the kitchen, everything goes a little bit faster. Now, our potatoes are getting nice and brown. you wanted to add some meat, which I had some sausage, you can take the sausage either out of the casing, or you could just chop up little pieces like this and add it to your hash.
Thank you.
With our hash, we're going to actually put it into nice little red pots so that you can serve it for your breakfast, either for Valentine's Day or just for whoever it is that you want to make a nice breakfast for. Now, growing up, I always hated breakfast. I really didn't like breakfast at all. I would eat spaghetti, right? For breakfast, I'd eat spaghetti meatballs all the time. And pizza all the time. And I remember when I came home from the hospital 1 year, I ate spaghetti for like 8 days straight, right? Is that how many days it was? Seven or eight.
I don't remember, but
it was, and I said, when I get home, I'm going to eat spaghetti every day. And I did. And I would even eat it cold. And I love when gluten-free grandma would make spaghetti pie. I love when you make spaghetti pie. But I always hated like breakfast food. I didn't like eggs. And I just wasn't really into that. I did like pigs in a blanket, which is our little version right here. I love pigs in a blanket, right? I would order that every time we went out, or Eggs Benedict, right? Love Eggs Benedict. But this was something that I found that I really loved, and I could eat this for breakfast, lunch, or dinner, and it just made my body feel good. So I'm wondering if back then I didn't like eggs because it just didn't make me feel good, or I just didn't like them. I don't really know what it was. But you guys loved eggs. You did, right? Jeremiah, you like eggs?
No.
I do have today a quail egg, but I'm going to tell you why I have a quail egg, and we'll talk about it in a minute. Let's just finish up what Jeremiah's doing. Can you show them, honey, what you're doing? He's just kind of squashing down the scone mix into the pan so it makes a heart shape, because we really wanted those to be heart shaped.
Oh.
So if you have a little bit more, that's it.
Okay.
That's so funny. Oh, you were going in there?
The double-decker donut.
So we had about 12. We had about 12 to 13 donuts, pigs in a blanket, breakfast poppers, whatever you want to call them, and Sophia's making something crazy right here.
There's
right
three sausages in
Why would you do that?
Because it's so cool.
It's going to come out, though. They're not going to stay in. All right, so she's making a crazy... She's crazy right here. It's coming all apart.
It's
we'll
the triple decker donut.
I should have wet my hand first.
Triple D.
Triple popper here. How are you going to get to eat this?
Me, Daddy.
Oh, Daddy's going to eat this?
Me.
Oh, you want to eat it. All right, I'm going to drop this in. This is going to take quite a while.
The double S. The double S.
Who knows if that's going to stay in or not. We'll see. But that would have been three donuts. Three of those right there.
Well,
all right, this is smelling really, really super good.
Sausage.
No, keep them out for now. You want sausage in here?
But you gotta have all the color.
That's not color. I'm talking about vegetables, not meat.
Meat helps you.
Meat helps you, but you don't need to have it. You can have just vegetable stuff. I don't want to put the vegetables in there. What we're going to do, though, is we're going to add a little bit of cheese, and we're going
to
do some spices.
What
Sophia, would
sausage?
You? That fell out. Would you spice me, please? Put this away. Over there. And then you're going to spice me. Jeremiah, you need to get those in the oven. So now, because our scones are not really super sweet, we're going to do a nice little drizzle with our excess. That's what I was afraid of. That, I don't want that to happen. I don't want Sophia to get... Did you get popped, Jeremiah?
No.
Oh, okay. I'm going to put the top on for now, because I don't want anybody to get hurt, because that just got me right in the arm. And I don't know what that was that just popped up. Did you see what that was, Gloria, Grandma? No. It was maybe a piece of sausage. On the triple D one. Yeah, I hear it popping. It's still popping. All right, I'm going to get our little red pot so we can fill them with our delicious little sweet potato hash. And Jeremiah's going to get us some cheese to grate. Thank you, honey. All right, I'm not going to do too much. I'm just going to do a little bit of cayenne.
Me.
I don't want to do too much, though. A little bit of turmeric. Now, this is all heart healthy stuff. Whoa, easy. There's no top on that.
Oh.
We need salt and pepper, and we need a little bit of garlic. Jeremiah, you can grate a little bit of that. Whoa, it's a good thing have the top on because that really went. Did you hear that?
Yeah.
All right, no more.
Three-decker is dangerous.
So we're using our nice red vibrant spices. These are all heart healthy spices. I read a book called Curing with Cayenne, and it's a really interesting book about cayenne pepper. And it talks about how. Now I'm not telling you to do this. I'm not advising you. I'm not your doctor.
That's true.
But it says how one man was having a heart attack, and they put some cayenne pepper on his tongue, and it revived him because it led the blood to his heart, which I guess was having a problem with. So that was very interesting. And the book is called Curing with Cayenne. It's a very interesting book. Okay, just salt and pepper. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to have to take this out.
It worked like a charm.
No, it didn't. It's popping everywhere.
My heart shrunk into a little baby heart.
All right, Jeremiah, that's good. Oh, okay. All right, so what I'm going to do is we have these beautiful little red puffs. Jeremiah, do you think... Get rid of the spices, please. Thank you. And I want to clean off our space here just for a little bit. Jeremiah, can you take this away, please? Thank you. And I'm going to fill our pots. Now, we already have our oven on, so we're going to do... Yes, we've got our... Thank you to Rose for our reserve cheddar. We're going to be putting this on top of our breakfast hash, and it's going to be really, really delicious. Now, we had two potatoes. If you have more people, you might want to use a little bit more. Especially if you're not using any meat, you might want to use a little bit more.
Grab that one. Actually, I want to do a pot.
All right, so I'm going to just fill these pots with some of our delicious... Jeremiah, don't do that yet, I don't think. Is that good?
Yeah.
Okay. We don't have the syrup on there, though.
It's good.
We've got our... Can you get me the other pot, please? Now, we have our eggs. I'm going to get our eggs out. Why don't you get the quail eggs for me, please?
Oh, my.
And what we're going to do is we can either pop the egg on top and bake this in the oven with the cheese, or we can cook it right in the pan here. All right, let me just do this. I'm going to fill these up a little bit more.
Now we have teeny tiny, and I mean teeny tiny.
Now we really had enough for about five people. And if you put the sausage in there, you'll have more.
Mommy,
you'll have enough for about...
Can't use this one. This one, I think, has mold in it or something.
No, honey. No.
There's a hole.
Oh, okay, well, we'll see. All right, so I'm going to just show you... These are the quail eggs. Excuse me for a minute, Sophia. Can you just let me do this? All right. They come like this. These are called BioVita. So this is 15 quail eggs. So I'm just going to read this to you real quick. Let me just pull this up. I'm going to keep them down a little bit longer. So I just want to read to you what this says. Quail eggs have 3 times as much vitamin B1 as chicken eggs, 5 times more potassium and iron, over double the amounts of vitamin A and B2. So in a little quail egg, you've got all of that. It's amazing. I don't know why the quails have so much goodness to them. It says it has 7 grams of protein in 5 eggs. So you're not going to eat all 5. I don't know if you will, but it's very interesting to read a little bit about the quail eggs and all of the goodness that they have. So if you want something a little bit different, you can go with a quail egg. Now they're really teeny, teeny, tiny. What?
Can I hand these out?
No, we need the egg and the cheese on top.
Can I crack
them? So let me do this one, please. So we're going to crack our little quail egg. They're hard. They're really hard shells. And we're going to just drop that into the pan. Oh, and I broke it. Now you want to be careful because the shell is hard, but it has like a skin inside. So it's a little bit hard to crack. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to...
Oh, wow.
Okay, let me do it because I don't want you to get hurt. Okay. Go ahead, drop it lower. Watch your fingers. So I'm going to just drop... What are you doing, Jeremiah? Okay, stop. Slow down. So I'm just going to cook the quail egg a little bit. I'm going to turn it. I want the yolk a little bit wet. So I'm going to flip it over. These are so cute, right, Mom? So 2 more. So yeah, the colors are pretty. You don't want to crack it like that. You just want to do 1 hard crack to it. And Sophia's having a rough time getting it out. You don't want any shells. Good girl.
So cute little egg.
Alright, one more. And I'm going to put a little bit of cheese on top.
I do it.
Go ahead. But there's a really tough skin inside, so I'm going to crack it.
I can do it.
Alright, come on over here, Jeremiah.
Make sure it doesn't splatter on you.
Got the little quail egg there? We've got breakfast toppers that are huge. Was that a double yolk?
No.
Oh, why did you put it on top of that one?
Oh, I didn't know. I wasn't supposed to.
No, okay, so we need one more, Sophia. Alright, so hold on one second. Let me get this out. So I'm going to just pull this one out. It's got a little bit of cheese on top. Now, hopefully, when you crack this.
Test number two.
Yeah.
Wait, hold on.
Test number two.
Oh no, I'm losing my egg.
Oh no, don't lose the egg.
Hopefully when you crack that, you'll have a little yolk.
What happened to that one?
Jeremiah broke the yolk. A little bit of cheese on top. It's okay. Alright, Jeremiah's gonna do it. Come on, buddy. No, no, don't do that.
Don't do that. That's how you break the yolk.
No, you're not doing that.
That's how you break the yolk.
Just crack it open. Stick your finger in there and pull it. You got shells. Hold on.
You and those eggs, they don't like you.
Well, he did it. It's in there. All right, so we've got one more yolk, one more quail egg.
Did I use the one with the holes? All
right. So what I'm going to do is just put this one on the top. Jeremiah, you can go take a picture of that. And we have
the one with the holes.
That's right, honey. Don't worry about it. Yeah, you can go and take a picture of that one. So what we're going to do is you can either serve them like this, or you can put the top on. Wrap a nice little napkin over it and serve it, and that would be your nice little brunch. Our brunches sometimes and our breakfasts are kind of a little bit crazy. So when you have fried donuts with maple syrup, we've got our breakfast toppers with a little bit of maple syrup on them. Now you just drizzle that on top, and you're good to go. Jeremiah, would you get me the Sophia, go get the tapioca for me, please.
Where is it?
In the back. So we've got our one last one here. A little quail. Those little eggs are so cute. Now, we should have probably greased our pan a little bit so they didn't stick.
I'm sorry, I gotta try one.
Come over here, honey. So our last thing we have to do is to make our little... to make our scone drizzle. Jeremiah, how are our scones coming, all right?
Oh, great. I took the one that has no sausage.
She took the one that has no sausage. That's funny. So we're using our tapioca. We're doing about 2 tablespoons of tapioca. And we're going to add about 1 teaspoon of our energy drink. I'm going to just mix that up a little bit. Now they're heart-shaped, yay! I'm going to just mix this up a little bit. We could also use a little bit of maple syrup. Jeremiah, can you move this and this out of over there? So we've got our tapioca in here with some excess, and we're going to make little drizzle for our scones. Now, we could use our scones that are not heart shaped, but you can wait a minute, okay? Thank you.
We're not using our scones. We have.
Jeremiah's going to start on our special drink that I picked for today. I'm going to put a little tiny bit, put it down, please. Little tiny bit of maple syrup.
Can I work it?
Yep, take it over to the market. And I'm going to take this because we don't need this anymore. Jeremiah can take this away. Actually, I'll take this while he's making a drink, and he's going to tell you all about what he's making for us today. What? Jeremiah's going to get some ice.
I'm getting 1 cube of ice. 1 cube of ice in each cup.
Now
we've got our breakfast here.
Then you take some cherries. Maraschino.
Oh, we love Till and Terry's.
Mommy,
we love them because there's no food coloring in them. They're colored with natural ingredients.
I think
Jeremiah.
Too much in.
Well, you
Why?
Did that. I
they
did
are
do that.
Maple
you
did. Like that
with
no,
the stem. And then you take a cherry and you put two in each.
You mean two
cup.
Cherries?
Two cherries.
Ooh,
they smell really good.
They smell so good, right? We love Till and Cherries. We love that they don't have any garbage in them. It's the one cherry
and
we
can have them.
Without any food coloring.
Then my friend can have
mm-hmm.
And then you take a little bit of juice and you put it in there.
Jeremiah, use the spoon, please, so you don't make a mess. I have this. Excuse me. All right, I'm going to test our little drizzle for our scone.
And then you take some seltzer and put it in there over the ice so it fizzes.
Jeremiah's using our favorite seltzer, San Pellegrino, from Bergamo, Italy, I believe. Jeremiah's doing a good job. He's our drink master.
Hey, don't take it yet.
Come out. Let them see what he's doing, please. I'm going to go check on our scone.
And then you take the cran grape excess energy blast mixer and you put just a tiny bit.
Teeny tiny.
Just enough to make it the red.
Blood red. Okay,
that's looking good for our Shirley Temple. Yummy. So, the reason why we use excess energy blast mixer is because it got a lot of vitamin B in it. Now, you always want to make sure you get your phytonutrients by taking your vitamins and by, you know, going with all of your colors and taking a supplement that's really good for you and healthy for you. You want to make sure that you hit on all of the colors, not just the red, which is yummy. Cheers, Sophia. To happy hearts. Cheers to happy hearts. Now, you know, we make our drinks in our household, but they're always virgin drinks. We don't put any alcohol in them. But if you want to go ahead and spice yours up, you can go ahead and do that for yourself. Now, it shows on here, the red ones are the heart healthy. The orange ones are the vision health, but they also included have other benefits, not just for vision, not just for brain. They help your entire body, so you always want to make sure that you're feeding good stuff to your body. Because everything you put in your mouth matters. So even though we're having a nice little fancy drink here, it's still a healthy drink for us, right? I love Shirley Temples. Growing up, I would hang out with my grandfather at my dad's restaurant, and I would have a Shirley Temple, and he would have a rum and coke. Remember, Grandpa would always have it? And my other grandpa would have wine and peaches, and I would have a Shirley Temple. So this was always a treat for us to get a cherry in our drink.
I like to let the cherry soak in the excess.
And those cherries are super, super delicious. So, all right, you guys each want to pick a pot?
Pick a pot.
Pick a pot?
I don't know which pot I'm giving you.
I'm going to pass out. We hope you guys B-Y-O-N. Thank you, honey. Sophia's going to give us our napkins and our forks. Now, for this breakfast, you need a pot. There you go. Now, for our nice little breakfast, you don't really need much. A little bit of maple syrup. This is yummy. You're gonna love this.
Take this one.
Pancakes and sausage.
Where's my double decker?
Pigs in a blanket.
Where's my double decker?
Yummy. That's not ready, Sophia. Mm. And we've got our nice little beautiful
Hey, it's wet
brunch.
On the inside.
Yep, you're supposed to have a nice wet yolk. Now, when you have that wet yolk, it just kind of seeps into your... Now, we can't forget our avocado. We want a little bit of sliced avocado
Whoever
on top.
Whoever gets the heart gets a kiss from me.
Okay.
Because the heart pepper gets a kiss from me.
Whoever's got the heart pepper, that's a good prize.
Mimi's got the heart pepper.
Did she?
I did.
Oh boy.
I think you just put it in your mouth.
Oh.
So we're going to add a little bit of our nice avocado. You guys want avocado?
No.
Some sliced avocado to that.
Mimer's just got
Jeremiah's looking for the heart because he wants
just a kiss
from Sophia.
I'll give you a kiss on
Mimer. Here you go, honey.
Did you get the heart or did Mimer's? I think Mimer's did.
You want to slice your avocado and maybe a little bit of salt and pepper on top. Mimer's needs her avocado, Sophia. Can you go grab that for her? Let me do it, please. We want to just slice it nice. You always put your knife in to pull out the pit there. And then we just do a nice little slice on the inside without going through.
That quail egg was good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And we're going to give that to gluten-free grandma.
Oh, this is so delicious. It tastes so healthy.
Tastes healthy? Yeah.
It tastes refreshing.
Avocado is a delicious addition to any of your breakfast. And you know the avocado craze.
We've been eating avocado before.
Just
see if
you have the heart.
But we don't want to forget your colors. You want to make sure you're hitting on all of those notes. Because they're so good for you. Mm. Now, Jeremiah's not a big fan of sweet potatoes. But you do like it this way, don't you? You don't like it this way? You only like when Miss Linda makes
potato.
It for you?
With beans and rice. Miss Linda.
Sweet potato chips and sweet potato bread or whatever rolls.
Oh, yeah, our sweet potato rolls, yeah. We didn't need those today. Honey, I don't see it, but
yeah,
thank
I
you.
I think Mimi's
had. This is yummy. Now, if you wanted to, you could put some ketchup or... We don't need anything on this, though. I think it's good the way it is. What about you? You gonna put balsamic on it?
Maybe.
He puts balsamic on everything. You've got that little quail egg, power packed. You've got all of your veggies in there. You got your beautiful Shirley Temple for your drink that's nice and healthy. What else? Oh, we have our scones still in the oven. Jeremiah, you want to take those out? Take them out, let's see.
Mm-hmm.
All right, just wait a minute, okay? Mommy didn't get to eat hers, so just wait. All right, so I'm going to get rid of this. I've got more of these big, huge, giant breakfast poppers that are not really, they're huge. We've got those nice, beautiful, small ones. They're all closed in there. And Jeremiah's got our scones. Now our scones, we're going to pop them right out. Yep, you want to bring them to Mommy? Nice little heart shapes. Can you, yeah, that's good. Can you bring me the cooling rack without the other ones on it? Now for the scones, you want to make it really simple. And you just want to drizzle the stuff on top. Let it cool off. It might need to be a little bit thicker than we have today because we got a little heavy hander over here like Mommy. Here, Jeremiah. I'll do it for you, honey. Turn them over so we see the backside. Did you grease the pan?
Good. Yeah.
Okay. So our pan was greased with our tiger nut oil. They probably need a second to cool before you can pull them out, but we don't want to leave you hanging like we did last week. We left you hanging with our fig and bacon pinwheels, and really, you know, they weren't my favorite way that we made them this time, because I think that crust that I had was the wrong one, but you can do a basic pie crust, or you could do a basic dough, and either way, you can fill that with your pinwheels, you can fill it with your fig and your bacon, and that'll be delicious. Easy, Sophia. Okay, you don't want to annihilate this. Mommy the knife. Put it down. Alright, so now we can get rid of this. Got our little heart-shaped scones. And what we're going to do is just drizzle them. Actually, let me put this underneath. Pop that off, Jeremiah. Or Sophia. And I'm going to put this underneath just in case I make a little bit of a mess drizzling. I'll put them all in the middle. They're probably a little bit too hot that's going to melt, but we'll do a little bit. Let me do some. Yeah, we've got, it's a little too hot, but I'll let Sophia do the rest. So we've got our little teeny tiny heart-shaped scone. A little soft. I like that little sweetness on top. We need to cook a little bit more. That's okay. That's good, baby. I'm going to try the other one. Jeremiah, where's the other one? Let me try it. They're cooled now, so maybe those will be, we'll be able to drizzle those. Let me try. They look nice inside.
try it. Just dip it in and try it. That's yummy. A nice little scone. All right, guys. You know what time it is? Time to go. Oh, thank you, Sophia, for your help today. What was your favorite thing? What was your favorite thing? My favorite food? Oh, favorite food. What's your favorite food today? Was it this, or this? Sophie liked this the best. Jeremiah, how about you? Your favorite was that? Gluten-free grandma, what do you say? What was your favorite?
Well, I only have that, but it was delicious.
Oh, you didn't have this yet. Oh, delicious. We got to feed gluten-free grandma. Your
delicious.
Breakfast with the quail egg, you like that?
Delicious.
All right, so I would have to say this is my favorite, too, than this and then this. But these have to cool off, and then I'll have to give you my real pick. Yeah, so, all right, we're done for today, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. We hope that you just spread the awareness of congenital heart defects. And we want you to, you know, go to the website. If you can, donate. If not, then maybe you can help or just spread the word or just repost their post just to get the word out. And we want you guys to come, taste, and see how good it is to be gluten-free. Have a great weekend, everybody. Ciao.
Aprons by REM Designs. Hair by Satinique. Makeup by Artistry. Thank you to our pantry partners and fridge friends. Follow us on Livestream, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, and YouTube at ABC Gluten Free. ABC Gluten Free is a production of American Vods. Ciao.
God bless everybody. Have a delicious weekend.